Well, there was a day-long celebration in Cebu as hundreds of thousands turned up for the homecoming and Thanksgiving mass held for San Pedro Calungsod. This report.
From the heavens, one can see the extent of gratitude of devotees for San Pedro Calungsod. Cebuanos gave a rousing welcome to the image of Calungsod, like a king coming home to the Queen City of the South. Images of other saints from Cebu churches joined the image of Calungsod in a procession. People of all ages endured the heat and the long walk for the saint, including Nida Katubig of Hinatilan, said to be the hometown of Calungsod.
Mainit pero masaya naman.
Bakit po?
Siguro sa faith.
The galleon San Diego arrived before 4 o'clock Friday afternoon to carry the image of San Pedro for the fluvial procession. There was a problem with sailing at first after the galleon slightly tilted, so a tugboat was sent for assistance.
Masibang pakpak kang San Pedro Calungsod!
At the South Road properties where the temple or altar where the mass will be held, thousands of devotees waited and rejoiced upon the arrival of the image.
Viva sa instrumento sa kalinaw!
Cebu Archbishop Ricardo Cardinal Vidal celebrated mass before a crowd of nearly 1 million. Even the most
elementary. President Aquino delivered a speech right after the Thanksgiving Mass. He said Filipinos should continue to be inspired by the life of the second Filipino saint. And giving us an update from Cebu is our correspondent Ryan Chua. Ryan?
Well, Tony, the Thanksgiving Mass for San Pedro Calungsod has already ended. But as you can see, celebrations in his honor continue. Right now, there's a concert by various youth groups here at the Templete for San Pedro Calungsod, here at the South Road Properties, a 27-hectare lot where the Thanksgiving Mass was held tonight. Now, earlier tonight, authorities say that around 1 million people attended the Thanksgiving Mass for the second Filipino saint who's believed to have been born and raised here in Cebu. The Mass earlier tonight was attended by top officials of the Catholic Church, including Cardinals Ricardo Vidal, Gaudencio Rosales, Luis Antonio Tagle, and Papal Nuncio Giuseppe Pinto. President Aquino and Vice President Jeju Marbinay were also in the Mass, along with other officials like Interior and Local Government Secretary Mar Rojas and Cabinet Secretary Jose Rene Almendras. Cardinal Vidal celebrated the Mass where he praised Calungsod's unwavering faith and expressed hope that he would be a good example to every Catholic. Now, in his message, President Aquino underscored the importance of remembering and living up to San Pedro Calungsod's ideals.
He proves how a single individual can bring about widespread change. This gathering also stands as testament not only to the holiness of St. Pedro Calungsod, but even more so to the ideals that he has etched into our national consciousness. A sense of selfless sacrifice for faith and principle, an outward offering of oneself for the greater good. These are the same principles we are called to uphold in our era. Much like Pedro, every day we are faced with our own temptations, our own crossroads. Centuries after his time, many of our fellow men still thirst for warmth and compassion.
Now, Tony, while youth groups are having a concert here, church officials and local government officials are having dinner and a program at the Cebu International Convention Center. Now, after all these celebrations, the image of San Pedro Calungsod will be brought back to its shrine at the Archbishop's compound. Tony?
All right. Thank you very much, Ryan Chua, for that update.